Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynet and welcome back to our XCOM 2 Commander playthrough with your characters in the game. So, we got a council mission, another communication brief from the council in which we need to extract another engineer, Daniel Martin. And if we get that guy, he's gonna help us out greatly with expanding our base, our mobile base, the Avenger. So on this mission we have Geralt, our Grenadier, Cedric, our seasoned sniper with his lightning reflexes, and then we have Humongous, our healer, Christoph, our amazing shotgunner ranger, and then of course Benito, our main specialist, our main hacker. So with that said, well, let's not wait around too long. Here we go. So we do have a lot of major characters now in the mission. I do want to keep a few of the rookies on later missions, but we're gonna have to wait with that for now, because I think this was I don't want to risk it right now. I just want to boost our current squad a bit, just in the hopes that we get them a few nice promotions, and then we're gonna work on the rookies.
We received a priority one transmission from the spokesman. The resistance has a VIP operating out of this area in need of immediate extraction. Advent forces are on alert nearby. Be prepared to engage and eliminate any hostile contacts. Secure the area and escort the VIP to safety.
So there we go. The reason I want to wait off with the rookies is that we're pretty close to getting... I don't know what the rank is immediately, but a certain rank of soldier that I think both Cedric and Benito are one rank away from that, where we can buy the next squad upgrade, where we can take 6 soldiers on the mission. So that's when we're gonna start using squaddies as well to boost our overall skill rating. Okay, we're dropped immediately apparently.
Menace 1-5, target coordinates incoming. Secure the VIP and proceed to the evac volume for extraction.
So, you might have seen that Christoph, because of his phantom ability, is the only one in concealment right now. So let's use him to scout around a bit, because they won't see him immediately. Oh, and we have action immediately. A sectoid and a lancer. Huh. Should we engage immediately? We don't have cover anyway, so... we might actually do so. Cedric, what's your shot? So we have a nice shot at both of them. I think the stun lancer is in this case the most dangerous one. So yeah, why not? We have all our turns left, so whatever they do we can adapt to it. So let's just fire the sniper rifle immediately. Bam! In the face! Wow, I saw that happening. That was a headshot immediately. That sector doesn't know what's happened. Yeah, I think you're a bit mad, right? You just saw his brains getting splattered all over the place. Okay, so he went inside. First things first, let's put the VIP in safety here. Let's put him just behind this wall. They're not gonna touch him. That's not bad. We actually have a shot for some reason. How the hell do you have a shot? Let's put you over here. Looks like a nice position. Full cover. Should still have sight. 53%. Not bad. We could use the shotgun, but that of course will break concealment as well. Let's put... who else do we have? We have Geralt. We could blow the wall right open, actually. But is it not too soon to use a grenade? You know what? Somebody else has a grenade. I think, yeah. Benito has a grenade. But is he gonna reach? Well, we're gonna have to see, right? There we go. Let's see how far your grenade reaches. You should only be able to... well, you can blast open the wall, which is... the only thing I really want to ask for, so... there... oh, wait, what? Did he even have a flank shot? He had a flank shot. Never mind, but he lost his cover anyway, so... let's see what we can do. We still have two Schultz, it seems. So 73 from Hugh, let's take it. He's not gonna get flanked anytime soon, which is good. And then the only thing we have left, if we don't want to give up his stuff, is Geralt's Schultz, which is 69 at the moment. No, so we have only Geralt's Schultz, so let's put him over here. In full cover. That's 70%. Yeah, that's pretty good. His minimal damage is 4, so if he hits, it's dead. Hopefully. And otherwise, I'm gonna have to... Is that a hit? Yeah, it's a hit. Thank you, Geralt, the Butcher. The Butcher of Blaviken. Thank you very much. So that's two enemies taken care of and a promotion for Geralt. That is anything I could have hoped for. So let's just hunker you down and let's put Christoph a bit further because there's nothing else here for now. But we do want to use him to scout everything out. We do hear something. I think it was over there, so... Let's put you over here. Should give you sight on the left. And being able to... Oh, that's not a door. Never mind, that is not a door. Let's put you over here.
Order's confirmed.
So we can check out if there's anything behind the building. Doesn't seem like it for now. We could get Cedric up here already, which might not be such a bad idea to prepare him for what is to come. We're gonna have to wait just a second. I do want to move everybody else up. Just one action first, just in case anything else happens.
Moving on target location.
Let's put Smongo at the door that
Je vais vers la position.
Christoph was at. There we go. Let's put Cedric up top. Don't think he should trigger anything. Nope. He doesn't. Benito over here. Let's check out on the civilian, the VIP we need to extract. Let's put him behind full cover over here next to the truck. We shouldn't be able to see him over there. And then we have Geralt. Just move him up behind full cover as well, just in case. Yeah, he doesn't have an Overwatch shot, but... We should get him closer as well, so...
Good copy. Moving on target.
And Smongo can be positioned... Let's just move him up a bit further, just in case we need the extra fire support. There we go, and that's everything. So, Christoph, do you see anything? Nothing yet. Do you want to have a look before we do anything rash? Because I think... Yeah, it's in a building across... Holy shit, we still have a ways to go. Let's put him over here. Okay. Nothing yet. You want to be careful, because I hear footsteps. I think they're over there, but I don't want to risk it just now. So let's put you over here.
Confirmed.
Ooh, this is gonna hurt. Okay, 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 okay. So they're far enough away that they don't see me yet. And they are far enough away for me to set up an ambush, actually. Christoph has sight over there on the right, so nobody should be able to spot Cedric here in his sniper's nest. That's high. That's two stories up. Nobody should be able to see him over there. And let's put the VIP behind the car. Don't want to risk him being seen. And let's put everybody on Overwatch now. Because if the aliens come this way, we can actually get a few shots in. Because they're gonna spot... Yeah, there we go. They're gonna spot the guys on the right now. There we go. Oh, yes. Did that hit anything? No.
La cible est toujours debout.
Ooh, they're behind the truck now. But we do have a nice shot from up here. They don't actually have that good a cover. They were very smart by putting the truck in our way. Because now we don't have a clear line of sight of any of them. So they actually took the defensive route. Smongo, you could probably get... Christoph's position. Huh. If I put you over here.
Heading to that location.
We're not breaking concealment just yet. But we do have a flank shot on the Stun Lancer now. I'm gonna wait with that. So Hugh, you could move. Oh, damn it. Okay, was kind of banking on that one. Can't get any higher either. I could. No. Ooh, this is actually a worse position than I thought it was. We don't have a lot of cover around here. Let's put you over there. I don't think you'll be able to see anything. Maybe the Lancer? No. Ooh, this is gonna suck. So the civilian, the VIP, is safe for now. But everybody else... I think it's gonna be a good time to break concealment with Christophe. Hopefully killing the Stun Lancer in one go. Otherwise, we're gonna have a bit of a problem. A bit of a problem, but... First things first, so we need to move Geralt up. I think, yeah, 3 spaces at the least. So that means putting him in open ground. This is gonna suck big time. But yeah, don't think I have much choice here. Ooh, I don't like keeping soldiers in the open, but... maybe I should try everything else first. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. I'm just gonna try and use the shotgun on the Stun Lancer first to see what happens. If it kills him, all the better. Oh, I do like the criticals of Christoph's shotgun. There we go, that's one down. And I break concealment. That's not bad. I wanted to break concealment. That was totally what I wanted to do. So now we... I kind of feel safer to put him out in the open. We're gonna use a grenade on both of them. We don't have a good shot right now, so what we're gonna do is a grenade right on top of these guys. Yeah, just gonna do that, breaking their cover as well, so they're gonna have to move if they wanna have a better spot. But what that does is actually make space for Cedric and his amazing sniping skills. I think that should give him 100% shots. And of course we have his... Wait, I wanted to check the percentages. So 100 on the trooper, and 100 on the advent officer. Okay, we're saved. We are saved. So lightning hands on the trooper. So Cedric, are you ready for a double kill? 98%. Okay. But that should do it. Ooh, in the face. And then just... Cedric, do you want to take the honors and kill that officer for me? In the face, preferably, because headshots are always amazing. Ah, no, straight in the gut. Straight in the gut. That was really nice. We took care of that like a champ. Okay, so let's put Benito closer, because we don't want to leave him behind. And that will make him available for further action in the future. And I think we still have Smongo left as well. So we know there's no enemies over here. So let's put him in full cover. So putting Cedric up there was probably the best decision I made today. And let's move our VIP behind this little wall as well. There we go. A little cinematic of Daniel Martin, I think his name was, walking towards that low wall. So now we don't have concealment anymore.
Hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position. Firebrand has a limited window to provide extraction.
Okay, so it's not that far ahead, but it's on top of a larger building, so we need to be careful. Not all the aliens are down. Oh yeah, he triggered something. I can't move. Yeah, there we go. Oh, they're right on top of the evac zone. Okay, so 2 basic troopers and a sectoid. Not too bad, actually. Let's see. So Cedric has a shot on all of them, which is great, as always. And then we could actually sort the sectoid over there, which might be a good way to end it. Let's put Benito a bit closer behind his full cover and see if he can shoot at anybody. Seems like he can fire on the sectoid. And Geralt still has a single grenade, which I'm gonna use. I'm gonna have to be careful not to take out the evac zone, though. I don't think I can launch it at both the sectoid and one of the troopers. I don't think I can. Ooh, and I don't want to... No, I don't want to do that. Because that pipe is the only way... Well, not the only way, but the closest way up there. So let's just wait on that. Except if I want to use the grenade to blow up the tree that the sectoid is hiding behind. Because he's the only one in full cover. The rest of those guys are in half cover. So let's blow up the tree. I think that's the best option here. Yeah, let's do that. And that should take care of that tree. And yeah, it evaporates completely. So now the sectoid is out in the open. I think Smongo could use another promotion. So let's give him the shot first. On the open sectoid, I think. Because the other guys... Yeah, okay. So on the open sectoid, 4 damage, please. Oh, everything is going so good today. I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. Okay, great work. So 2 enemies left. 2 troopers on the higher level. So I can't use... Oh, that's too bad. I can't use Benito anymore. I can use Cedric with his sniper shots, which are good. And I still have a shotgun shot at both of them. Do I want to risk it? So if I want to shoot the sniper rifle, it's on the left guy, so the one with the 73% shot. So let's try that first, hopefully killing him in the head. Oh, I love his sniper rifle. I love Terelia. Don't tell him I said that though. Okay, so that's done. And now I'm doubting whether I should use the flashbang. Can I even use the flashbang up there? Can I toss it inside? Because I don't think that it's gonna affect him. Oh wait, it might. Yeah, okay, I can put it inside there. So I'm just gonna throw the flashbang. And that should be able to... so he's disoriented. So diminishing his aim immensely. Let's put you actually behind this wall here and hunker down, because... That would be nice. It wouldn't be nice if they start shooting at you now, would it? And let's put Benito on Overwatch, just in case the trooper decides to jump down like an idiot. So we're still disoriented. Hopefully he doesn't do anything stupid. Well, stupid, that causes me to... Okay. Okay, so he's on Overwatch. So that's actually not bad, because I can actually just shoot him from here. But I'm going to try and do that a bit more graceful. Why don't we? Smongo, you want to have another kill? You can try, 53% shot. Oh, nope, okay, missed, not bad. Just wanted to give you the option. Then we have the shotgun. I'm just gonna go around trying the shots. Nope, that's a hole in the wall as well. You need to take care of my my turns there. Okay, and then we have Benito. Let's give you a shot. Can you... Oh shit, Overwatch. Oh, I kind of forgot about that. But he must miss, right? Did he just hit an Overwatch shot disoriented? I completely forgot about the Overwatch shot. I was so excited I just forgot about the Overwatch shot. Oh, that's gonna hurt. But he got his revenge, though. That was stupid. That was really, really stupid. Okay. I am gonna put... Still have 6 turns. I still have 2 turns to get that. I don't want to trigger anything else for now. So let's just put them in Overwatch and keep everybody here. So let's... No, I'm just gonna put you downstairs already, Cedric. I don't want to risk you getting hurt. Move. Sorry about that Overwatch shot. I really should have seen that. I just wanted to give everybody a shot, but that kind of bit me in the ass. Okay. So that's good on that account. So let's give... I'm gonna put Smongo over here.
Okay, Shabush.
Just take another look. Doesn't seem like there's anything that needs, attention. Any one of the aliens that needs shooting. So let's heal Benito. Hopefully he's not out for too long, because I really need my specialist. Okay, so 3 HP healed. There we go. Let's put Christophe right in this little area, getting the loot. What is in there? An Illyrium core. Not bad, not bad.
Got some goods here.
I always like Illyrium cores, so let's put Benito closer. Could we actually get inside of the evac zone? Not yet. But I might want to put Geralt inside of there. Let's put him over here.
10-4.
Seems like we actually can move everybody up. And then we have Cedric, the only one not in the area yet. There we go. And then carefully evac everybody. Don't press the wrong button. Not that it would be so disastrous at this point. But I'm always scared I'm gonna just use the wrong action. There we go. Evac. Evac. And evac. There we go. Mission completed. Easy as that. With our fingers in our noses.
Mission accomplished.
So for... I do hate that I got Benito wounded, but sorry about that, guys. But we killed more enemies per turn than we ever did, apparently. Cedric dealt the most damage. Benito moved the furthest and was under fire most. And Geralt made most attacks again. Well done, guys. We got out of a few tough patches, but we got out of that mostly unscathed. And this time, I'm pretty sure we got two promotions. And Geralt and Humongous both got a promotion. I'm pretty sure about that.
One by one, we're evening up the score, Commander.
Oh, wow.
Good work out there.
So, Christophe got a promotion as well, and Benito as well, and he's only wounded for 5 days, so that's not bad. Cedric is leading, by the way, with 13 kills so far, and Benito close behind with 11 kills. But, Geralt, what can you do for us? And now it's getting really, really interesting. Demolition. Unleash a volley of bullets at your target's cover, significantly damaging or destroying it. Deals no damage to your target, though. And suppression. So, firing a barrage that pins down a target, granting reaction fire against it if it moves, and imposing a minus 50 penalty to the target's aim. Demolition might be situationally interesting, but I like suppression a lot more, because that we can use that a lot more in more situations than demolition. So here we go, suppression. Then we have Humongous, so more healing, I suppose. So now we can do... We can choose. We can go for Revival Protocol, so that can heal any negative mental status effects, including actually unconsciousness, disorientation, stunning, and panicked. So even panicking, that could be really handy. I do need to remember that, because I keep forgetting that a medic can actually cure panic as well. So let's go for Revival Protocol, because we have a hacker in our team for now. Then, Christophe, what nice abilities are you going to get us? Shadow Strike, while concealed, gain 25 bonus to aim and a 25 bonus critical hit chance. When attacking from concealment, we only are in concealment once in a turn, so that's not really that handy. But Shadow Step, this soldier does not trigger Overwatch or reaction fire, so that's immensely helpful to move through an Overwatch shot. So yeah, we're gonna take Shadow Step. There we go. And then we have Benito, who he's a lieutenant right now. So Field Medic. Equipped medikits have 2 extra charges. He's not our medic, sadly. So we're gonna go for Scanning Protocol. I'm gonna have to wait until the text moves back up to read that. So the Gremlin can trigger an instant scan of the area, increasing the specialist's sight radius substantially for one turn, and revealing any hidden or disguised enemies in view, which can actually reveal what are they called, the faceless in retaliation mission. So that's going to be really handy as well. So Scanning Protocol. So all promotions checked. Let's continue on to the loot. So 1 Illyrium core. Our engineer, look at how fancy he looks, Daniel Martin.
Excellent work, Commander.
So an engineer and 85 intel.
Resistance movement across the globe.
Let's see, we could increase the power of the Avenger, but I think I'm gonna use him to speed up the clearing of alien machinery over here. So let's move that up. So decreasing that by 50%, I think. So now it's only 7 days anymore from the 12 it was. So not 50% per se, but never mind. So there we go. We still have power for one more room, which is gonna be the proving grounds probably. And then we're gonna move back to the bridge. So now that we have the extra engineer, we're gonna be able to add more more power to the Avenger.
Avenger plotting new.
I wasn't
course.
Doing anything else. I think I was speedy healing. Yeah. So there we go. So let's get those supplies. Scanning.
Incoming.
But of course, another resistance communication. That was fast. Oh yeah, that's the monthly report.
Resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
So we get the best grades you can get. So one guerrilla ops completed, council mission completed, supply raid. Two regions contacted and a resistance rumor. So that were only three missions in that entire month. That might be bad. So we do get the 240 supplies if we get to the supply drop. But that's actually weird that we only got three missions. Ooh, I do wanna disable that UFO, please. Please. Oh god, so now we have a third hidden event. We can actually reveal that by using a bit of our intel. I don't want to do that just yet. And the other new dark event is Advent Alloy Padding. Advent invests in improving their battle gear, adding armor to some of their soldiers in the field for a month. So we've seen armor on the turret, so that were those two or three yellow spots. So that I explained that previously, armor just is diminishes the damage you get. So that works on the enemies as well, the same way. So there we go. So, supply drop, I'm gonna ignore that for now and just gonna continue scanning those. Well, no, I'm gonna go for the supply drop first because it's 5 days for these and 3 days for this one. Yeah, I'm not finished,
Avenger,
I know, but I'm hopefully gonna return there. Hopefully I'm going to return there. So let's get our supply drop. It's substantial, okay. And the Avatar project
Commander,
has some more progress.
Continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
So he says we need to move fast, but we still have a lot of time. We still have 8 blocks until we start the Doom timer. But let's start scanning for our supplies. Okay. This is very nice. New toys. So magnetic weapons.
These magnetic-based weapons are a lot like the early railgun prototypes. They fire projectiles at extremely high velocity.
Blam! So that's a bit more like the alien weaponry, so what the troopers use. And that boosts our weaponry a lot as well. So, new item available, magnetic rifle, shotgun, and the mag pistol. So if I'm not mistaken, the magnetic rifle is the assault rifle, shotgun is the shotgun, and the mag pistol is of course the pistol. So there we go. So having finally gotten a closer look at the Gauss rifles technology Advent has deployed among their forces, I'm fairly confident we can develop a magnetic weapon system of comparable power. The obvious question, why not simply use the Advent weapons directly, was discovered early on by resistance forces in the field. Some years ago, the aliens began integrating a sort of genetic verification technology into their weapons that prevents them from functioning by any species whose DNA has not been pre-encoded. So that's why we can't use the weapons the aliens use. Unfortunately, the system also exerts lethal force on an unsuspecting, unauthorized user, a fact we should disseminate as widely as possible among the resistance cells we have contact with. As for our own variation on the technology, Dr. Shen and I have taken components of the alien weaponry recovered from the field and utilized the key elements to develop a sustainable prototype. We can safely begin reproducing the system as the needed materials become available. So, pistol. Shotgun is a shotgun and a magnetic rifle. We do need to buy these separately, but when we buy them once, they are available for all our troops. So sectoid autopsy is now instant, so we're going to do that next because we don't lose time with that.
Though I was never witness to one myself, countless observers attest to the existence of a much smaller, less intimidating variant of the sectoid that took part in the original invasion. In the time since, this new being the product of clear genetic manipulation, is now a familiar face to our forces operating in the field.
So, of course, as you know, in the previous game, sectoids were a lot smaller.
The rapid physical evolution over the past 20 years is a testament to both the aliens' mastery of genetic engineering and their pursuit of advancement, regardless of the risks.
Although my direct surgical experience is limited, the aliens' genetic manipulation of the species previously catalogued as a sectoid provides a certain familiarity in relation to the human anatomy. While the earliest documented accounts of sectoids on Earth indicated examples no larger than 1 meter in height, the specimens we encounter today are all nearly twice that size. Knowing full well that the aliens continued their efforts to integrate human and alien DNA, my findings here only reinforce the notion of a continuous development process. This larger sectoid variant has an even greater proportion of human genetic material, selectively combined with the intention of improving the otherwise limited physical capabilities of the original. With enhanced psionic capabilities and greater overall strength, I'd say they've succeeded. So they combined the sectoid from the previous game with human DNA, improving their physical appearance and their psionic capabilities. But with that autopsy completed, we now can create a mind shield capable of defending our troops from mental attacks. And that's that, so let's add new research. So we have a few new things. So we can invest in Gauss weapons, which is actually the magnetic variant of the sniper rifle. We still do a lot of damage with our sniper rifle, so I'm gonna hold off on that. We could already research psionics as well. Plated armor would also be very nice, so increasing the defense of our troops. I'm doubting which one I should select next. I think resistance radio should not be bad, so let's try that first. So 6 days for resistance radio.
I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
You know what? No, let's not go to the bridge. We just got our new toy, so let's see how much that costs actually. The engineering bay, of course. So let's go to engineering. There we go.
Hey, Commander.
Let's see. View build items. There we go. So mind shield is added, and we need to... So 75 supplies for the shard gun. We got a lot of aloes from the supply raid we did. So right now we have a limited amount of soldiers that use the assault rifle. I think we have our two specialists. And that is it, actually. So I should... Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna buy everything eventually, so let's go with the magnetic rifle, which needs the boost first. There we go. And now we can't buy anything else. But we are close to our supply drop. Oh, sorry. Because I went straight to the bridge, she got cut off there. So let's get this. So 80 supplies.
Commander, the aliens have made significant progress toward their goals. New advent facilities are cropping up around the world.
So let's see, let's view that facility. It's way down in South America, it looks like. So now we can get to that mission. Well, we have that mission available if we actually get there. And that adds two more blocks to the Avatar project. So you can see that it could go very fast if we're not really careful. But let's keep scanning for those supplies.
Advanced Warfare Center now operational.
So this is cool. So the Advanced Warfare Center. Let's view the facility. So the Advanced Warfare Center improves the rate at which our soldiers heal. I think it halves it automatically. But we could put the available engineer in here already. So that would increase the soldier's healing rate. We could also retrain soldier abilities over there in exchange for a few days of our time. Do I want to add an engineer there? I don't think I want to. You know what? I am going to. Because we have a few injured soldiers that could benefit from the increased healing rate. Let's see. Could die. Yeah. There we go. And one more day. Yeah, okay. We got it. We got all our supplies. So let's ignore that. And ignore the new staff as well. So let's hop out first. Go back to engineering and buy everything else.
Hello, Commander.
And with everything, I mean the two weapon upgrades, because we only have the nanoscale vest over here. We don't really need that. So another pistol, which is going to really help Cedric with his lightning reflexes. And then the shard gun, the shotgun, which is going to help out Christophe, of course, our ranger. So that's that. I don't think we need any more items aside from that, so let's get back to the bridge. There we go. And let's go to those other supplies. They're still available, which is really, really good. Take it easy. Don't spawn anything just yet. I do want to spend a few days scanning over there. One day... Oh, and they all recovered from their wounds, which is really, really good. So the machinery is cleared again. Okay, that's really good. We still have 3 power left, so let's build the Proving Ground or the Resistance Combs. I think it's high time we get the Proving Ground, so let's do that. Let's
build. Commander, we've pushed our current power systems to the limit. We don't have any capacity to spare, which means we can't expand our facilities further.
But we can, I think we can excavate without having the available power. So let's put Daniel Martin on the excavation process already. We got a few supplies from clearing it out as well. So that funds the rooms as well. Let's see. So that's good. We could upgrade the power relay, but we're not going to do that just yet, I think, because that costs, 80 supplies. Let's move back to the bridge, yes. And then keep scanning. I don't think we're going to reach that. Ooh, resistance radio is complete already.
Though it is intriguing.
So the Avenger serves our purposes adequately in terms of coordinating our communications network, but if we hope to increase our range and reach every possible outlet, we will have to do more. A series of carefully positioned relay towers would suffice, assuming we can miniaturize the technology we've adapted from the aliens' own communications equipment. It may be difficult to balance the requisite power levels versus the increased chances of detection, but this is our best chance to expand on our capabilities. With the increased coverage, we can expect the efficiency of local resistance group operations to improve, strengthening the groups working within range of the tower. Which is good. Okay. I don't think we should wait with plated armor too much longer. So I think God's Weapons also makes us a machine gun for the heavies. I think I'm gonna go with armor for now.
I foresee a number of valuable applications.
So there we go. But I do want to have a Gorilla Ops really, really quickly to take out that UFO, because if we don't...
Commander, based on my research in collaboration with Shen, I believe we can reduce the intel costs of contacting additional regions by building radio relay towers along our network. The further a region is from a relay, the more it will cost us in intel. So I would suggest building relays along the remote edges of our existing network. I believe the Resistance will be grateful for the construction of these relays. They may reward us in kind.
So the relays are the result. So there we go. The relays are the result of the radio resistance radio research project, and this adds this over here. So now we have the continent bonuses. So the continent bonus on Asia is actually black market items cost 33% less intel. And for that we need to make contact with all of the areas, so New India should be included. So that's the green bars, and the two dots next to it is the amount of relays we actually have. The Start Resistance HQ is a relay as well, and we can put another relay in either of the other areas, so probably best in New India, just to spread it out a bit. Let's check out the other continent bonus. So fire when ready. All experimental ammo, grenade and weapon proving ground projects are completed instantly in Europe. Then we have... Oh, we can't see them yet, apparently. But we might see it over here, yeah, so Oceania. All intel rewards increased by 25%. They're all randomized every time you play the game, so they're not great this time around, but we might have some use for a few of them. But let's keep scanning the supplies. Oh yes, thank you. Please, please let me take care of that UFO.
Commander, with the number of contacts we've established, we're getting requests for support from multiple sites around the world. Unfortunately, we only have the resources to respond to one of them. The decision is yours.
So now we can choose which dark event we can counter. So we have the 3 available target sites, and each one of them has a different reward and a different counter. So we want to take out the UFO. I don't want to have that UFO coming after us. So difficulty moderate, 183 supplies, which is actually the best reward in my mind as well. We could use the engineer, that's right. And it's an easier mission, but I do want to take out that UFO. We don't want a UFO on our ass. I'm first going to check out something else. So ignore that for now. I think now that we have a lieutenant, we might actually have the next upgrade available. No. Okay, squad size 2 requires a captain, which is not that great. We have a few other really good upgrades available right now because of the lieutenant rank. So integrated warfare increases PCS bonuses. We don't have that many chips integrated already, so not that useful for now. So let's get back to the bridge and start that guerrilla operation as well. You know what's coming. So there we go, guerrilla ops, and take West Asia.
Setting course for West Asia.
Because we really, really don't want a UFO. There we go. And is this going to be... So Benito is back, which is really good. Most of them have magnetic weaponry right now. And I do like this setup, actually. It's a moderate mission. I don't want to take a rookie with me, because that might end badly. Because I still want to boost these guys a bit. If we can get a captain... if we can boost Benito a bit further, we can get a captain and improve our squad size. I move rupees alongside with that. So this is gonna be the squad we're gonna head out with, I think. Our best guys, just get them to the next level. That should be fine. But before we do that, we're gonna take a little break. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give the thumbs up to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!